Hello kids, how do you do? Doing good? Great. Let's remember a quote by Benjamin Franklin, that is, lost time is never found again. Yes, time is precious. So keeping this in mind, let's begin our chapter Time, which is our 10th chapter. So children, this is the mind map for our video Time. So under Time, we would learn about the units of time. Under time, we have smaller units as well as bigger units. So what are the smaller units? Seconds, minutes and hours. And under bigger units, we have days, weeks, months and years. And also we would learn the conversion of units. And what else we learn? We would learn about reading the time through AM and PM, and also about 24-hour clock and 12-hour clock. And then we would learn to add and subtract time, and also calculating duration of time. So children, this is a clock, and you all know the units related to time. What are they? Hours, minutes and seconds. So what can you see here? You can see numbers from 1 to 12, and also the hours hand and minutes hand. And in some clocks we can also see the seconds hand, isn't it? And what else we see? There are smaller divisions here, isn't it? So in between each number there are 5 divisions. So the smaller divisions represent seconds or minutes, and the bigger divisions, that is the numbers here, represent the hours. So one number is 1 hour. And now we see the hours hand has passed 10, so it is 10 hours. And now the minutes hand have reached 5, so that means it is 5 into 5, so the minutes is 25. So what is the time? It is 10 hours and 25 minutes. 10:25 it is, isn't it? So this is how we find the time in a clock. So children, we learned about the units of time. Now let's move on to the conversion of time units. So 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So the second hand in the clock moves one complete round, so it becomes 1 minute. And 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So the minutes hand take one complete round, so that it becomes 1 hour. So let's move on to a question, that is, convert 2 minutes 43 seconds to seconds. So we already know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So what will be 2 minutes? It is 2 into 60. 2 into 60 is 120. So 2 minutes is equal to 120 seconds. So now we converted this minutes to seconds. Now the process is easy. We have to just add 120 seconds and this 43 seconds. So when we add, we get 163 seconds. Therefore, 2 minutes 43 seconds is equal to 163 seconds. So now let's move on to another question, that is convert 10 hour 9 minutes to minutes. So as I already told, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So 10 hour will be 10 into 60. So 10 into 60 is 600 minutes. So 10 hour is equal to 600 minutes. So 10 hour we got as 600 minutes. So just add 9 to it. So we get 600 plus 9, that is equal to 609 minutes. So 10 hour 9 minutes is equal to 609 minutes. A day consists of 24 hours, but our clock has only 12 numbers in it. So it represents 12 hours. That means a clock display same time twice a day, isn't it? So the time from 12 noon to 12 in the midnight is considered as PM. That means whatever the time is, write the time followed by PM, that is post meridian. And from 12 midnight to 12 in the noon is considered as AM. So the time followed by AM, and that is called as antimeridian. Let's move on to the topic 24 hour clock. Have you seen a 24 hour clock? That is the clock in which all 24 numbers are there. In railways and airlines, we can find such clocks. In those type of clocks, the time is represented as a 4-digit number. The first 2 digits represents the hours, and the remaining digits represent the minutes. So how to compare 12 hour clock and 24 hour clock? In 24 hour clock, there is no concept of AM and PM. But in 12 hour clock, we have antimeridian and postmeridian, isn't it? So in a 12 hour clock, whatever we represent in AM, it remains the same for a 24 hour clock. Only the PM changes. So I have some questions here. In a 12 hour clock, time 5 PM is given. So how to represent it in a 24 hour clock? We have to add 12 to it because it is in PM. If it was in AM, that would be the same in 24 hour clock. Since it is in PM, we have to add 12. So when we add 12 to 5, we get 17. So 5 PM can be represented as 17 hours in a 24 hour clock. And here there is 1940 hours. So it is more than 12, isn't it? So when we convert it to a 12-hour clock, we have to subtract 12 from 1940. So when we subtract, we get 7:40 p.m. So 1940 hours can be represented as 7:40 p.m. in a 12-hour clock. Recently, we have learnt the chapters addition and subtraction. Now, let's learn addition and subtraction in time. So, how to add or subtract time? So, what do we have to do? We should first make columns of hours, minutes and seconds. And then start adding from seconds column. So when you add, if you get a number greater than 60 in seconds or minutes, we have to regroup it. For example, if you get 80 seconds, then regroup it as 60 seconds plus 20 seconds. So 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute, and that 1 should be taken to the minutes column. I'll show you a question so you can understand it easily. So the question is, add 2 hours 50 minutes 43 seconds and 5 hours 24 minutes 35 seconds. So do as usual, start from this side. So when you add 43 and 35, let's add here. When you add, we get 5 plus 3 is 8 and 4 plus 3 is 7, 78. So 78 is greater than 60. So we can split it as 60 plus 18, isn't it? So 78 seconds can be written as 60 seconds plus 18 seconds. So we know that 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute. So that 1 should be taken here and 18 should be written here. So we write 18 here and 1 is taken to the minutes. Now when we add 1, 50 and 24, let's see what we get. So when you add, we get 0 plus 4 plus 1 is 5 and 5 plus 2 is 7. We got 75. 75 is also greater than 60. So it can be written as 60 plus 15. So 75 minutes can be written as 60 minutes plus 15 minutes. So 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. So that 1 should be taken to hours column, okay? And the 15 can be written here. 1 hour, that is 60 minutes, is taken here. Now add all this. 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 5 is 8. So when you add 2 hours 50 minutes 43 seconds and 5 hours 24 minutes and 35 seconds, we get 8 hours 15 minutes and 18 seconds. Now let's see subtraction of time. So do as we did in addition. Make columns for hours, minutes and seconds, and then start subtracting from seconds column. So when the minute is smaller than the number to be subtracted, then what you have to do is take a borrow from the left side. So if we have to take borrow to the seconds column, then what we have to do is take 1 from here. So when you take 1 minute to the seconds column, it becomes 60 seconds. So we have to add 60 to this number. So here I have a question. Subtract 7 hours 45 minutes 15 seconds from 9 hours 15 minutes and 20 seconds. So let's start subtraction. Here when you subtract 20 minus 15, we get 5. Since 20 is greater than 15, we need not take a borrow. And when we move on to minutes column, 15 is smaller than 45. So we have to borrow from hours column. So when you borrow, this 9 will become 8. And when you take 1 hour to minutes column, it becomes 60 minutes. So 1 hour is 60 minutes. So 60 is taken to minutes. Now add 60 to 15. So this 15 will become 60 plus 15, that is 75. So 15 has become 75. Now 75 is greater than 45, so we can subtract easily. So 75 minus 45 is 30. Here 8 and 7. 8 is greater, so 8 minus 7 is 1. So the difference is 1 hour, 30 minutes and 5 seconds. Now let's move on to the topic time duration in hours and minutes. The time taken to complete an activity, that particular time is called as the duration. So some activity may take just a few minutes. Some activity may last for hours, isn't it? So now let's see how to find the duration of time. So children, the question is, Deepak left for shopping at 8:10 a.m. and returned home at 1:40 p.m. How long did Deepak stay out of the house? So we have to find the time duration for which Deepak has stayed outside. So here the time at which Deepak left is 8:10 a.m. and he returned at 1:40 p.m. So what is the time gap? The time from 8:10 a.m. to 1:10 p.m. it is 8:10, 9:10, 10:10, 11:10, 12:10, 1:10. So total 5 hours. So this is 5 hours. And from 1:10 p.m. to 1:40 p.m. the total time is 30 minutes. So Deepak stayed outside for 5 hours 30 minutes. Now let's move on to the topic calendar. A calendar displays year, month, weeks and days. So if you carefully notice, the year, written as 2020, the month as January, and the weekdays Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, etc. And the days are also given. So a year has 365 days and 52 weeks. What about 2020? 2020 is a leap year and it has 366 days. And in a normal year, there are 28 days in the month of February. But in 2020, in the month of February, we had 29 days because 2020 is a leap year and there are 53 weeks in this year. Okay, now let's see conversion of days, weeks, months and years. I have a question here. Convert one leap year and 6 weeks into days. So we already know one leap year has 366 days, isn't it? So one leap year is equal to 366 days. And how to convert 6 weeks into days? We know 1 week has 7 days. So 6 week will have 6 into 7, that is 42 days. Now we converted 1 leap year and 6 week into days. What is left? Just add both. So when you add 366 and 42, we get 408 days. So 1 leap year and 6 week has 408 days. Okay, the children, I have one more question for you. Convert 3 leap year into months. So in a normal year and a leap year, there are 12 months. The number of months won't change. Okay, so 1 leap year has 12 months. So what about 3 leap years? Multiply 3 by 12. When you multiply, we get 36 months. So 3 leap year has 36 months. Okay, so children, now let's move on to the topic time duration in days. So when you get questions like this, first you should know the number of days in the given month. Okay, so in a year, 7 months has 31 days and 4 months has 30 days, and 1 month, that is February, has 28 days in a normal year and 29 days in leap year. Okay, so I have a question here. A family went for a holiday on the 27th May and returned home on the 9th of June. For how many days did the family go out? So we have to find the number of days for which the family had gone out. So the number of days in May is 31. So the family went out on 27th May. So the total number of days in the month of May is 31 minus 27. So we get 4 days. So in the month of May, they were out for 4 days. And in June, up to 9th, they were out. So total number of days in June is 1 to 9, that is 9 days. So when you add both 9 and 4, we get the total number of days they spent out. So 9 plus 4 is 13 days. So the family went out for 13 days. So this is how to solve the problems. Okay, so children, in this video we learned about time, right? We learned the units of time. The smaller units are seconds, minutes and hours, and the bigger units are days, weeks, months and years. And we also learned the conversion of units. What else we learned? We learned reading the time through AM and PM, and about 24-hour clock and 12-hour clock. And we also learned to add and subtract time, and also calculating the duration of time. And one more thing, children, in your textbook, in exercise 10.5, the year given there is 2021. Change it to 2020. So the question will be, look at the calendar of the year 2020 and answer the following questions. There are so many questions given here. Look at the calendar and answer those. So once again, remember the quote by Benjamin Franklin, that is, lost time is never found again. Take care. Bye.